Hi, I'm Tom Luschiavo, Education Manager at PASCO Scientific.
And I'm Ron Fieldhouse, a Training Specialist here at PASCO.
And today we're going to talk to you about the wireless pH sensor.
Yes, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how it comes and take it out of the box and use it. So first off, it comes in two pieces. We have the actual pH probe and the amplifier box. They connect with a BNC connection, very typical. You just turn it until it clicks. Now you could keep it like this, or you could store them separately. Personally, I just click it like this and leave it. All right, there is a battery in the back which you won't have to change very often, but it's a simple one that you could buy at the grocery store. It's also waterproof. We can dip it in and for a few moments and you shouldn't have any problems, so spills are no big deal. All right, it comes with a storage solution. I'm gonna pull that off. This is a 4-molar potassium chloride solution. It's gonna get spilled in your classroom. We sell replacement, you could make your own also. The top, we can either slide all the way or simply take it off. I like to take it off. All right, and that's the pH sensor. What I'm going to do is turn it on, and I know it's on when I see the red flashing.
So now what we wanna do is we wanna be able to connect that to our software. So I'm using Sparkvue software, and I'm just gonna go into the Bluetooth settings. And because this is a BLE device, I can use in-app pairing. So once I hit that Bluetooth button, it'll find the device. I can just touch the device based on the number. The number's right on the top. So if there's a classroom full of them, you can identify the correct one. Once I touch it, it'll know that it's connected because this green battery will show up and because
the light's starting to turn green.
So I'm gonna hit done. And now my pH measurement will show up on the screen. So in most cases, if you're just doing relative measurements of pH, then you can just start using the pH sensor right now. If you feel like you need to calibrate, then there is an easy way to calibrate, and you can check out our separate video for doing that. But you'll just use some pH buffers.
Two buffer solutions, in there for a moment, put it in there for a moment, and it's pretty much calibrated.
Right. And that's very useful if you want to do very quantitative measurements, or if you notice that your pH sensor is a little bit off and you want to recalibrate it. Let's take a quick measurement and do a little quick experiment.
Okay, I've got some vinegar here. So when I place it in here, I would expect the pH to move towards the acidic level.
So, and it does, it's definitely acidic. It's down around 2.6 right now.
About 3, that's what I would expect for vinegar.
So right on my home screen, I'm just gonna touch that measurement to create a graph. And I'm gonna simply touch the green button to go. And there's my pH on a graph. And we'll see that change by adding a base.
I've got a little Alka-Seltzer here, which is gonna buffer that solution. So I'm gonna stir it just a little bit to make sure I got a nice even mixing of these chemicals.
And I'll auto-scale it so we can see the magnitude of the change here. Right, so there we go, that pH is definitely climbing as that base was added.
And it should plateau after a while.
So that's a quick overview of the pH sensor. Out of the box, what to expect. Calibration is simple if you need to do it. Waterproof, rugged, and ready to use.
Hey, thank you for watching.
Thank you.